disparities in the incidence and mortality of cancer in Brooklyn, New York, and the United States, so.
Hi, so my name is Olivar, and I'm a high school student that has interned at Brooklyn Health Disparity Center in Brooklyn, New York for the past 2 years. I'm also a research volunteer at SUNY Downstate Medical Center, where I investigate colon cancer inflammation in response to chemotherapy in black cell lines. And I'm going to be presenting today a little bit about disparities, health disparities in the Brooklyn community compared to the United States as a whole. So the first thing to sort of illuminate this topic is an idea of the demographic breakdown of Brooklyn versus the United States. So SUNY Downstate, where I spend most of my time doing research, is astounding 91% black. And that's significantly greater than the United States black population, which is around 16%. The data that I'm looking at looks at Brooklyn, which is around 39% black. So almost three times greater than the United States. As you can see, the black and Latin population increases as you get more and more local to the East Flatbush area, which is where SUNY Downstate Medical Center and Brooklyn Health Disparity Center is located. So health disparities for the last few decades have been omitted in the mainstream media, aside other social justice issues. But thankfully, I think in the past few years, it's gotten more attention as journalists realize that the heart attacks and strokes often kill more blacks and Hispanics in the United States than mass incarceration or police brutality. And that's heartening to see all the new press attention that's coming out of it. So for the data set that we looked at for this abstract, for this study, we looked at the Surveillance Epidemiology and Results Database, which is conducted by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. And we looked at the years 2010 to 2014. So this database essentially looks at all the about 20 different cancers all across the United States and is split up by counties. And you can filter by age, race, gender, and a variety of other factors. So we look at two different areas, Kings County or Brooklyn, and the whole United States. We also look at two different factors, incidence and mortality of cancers. We look at two different races, non-Hispanic whites and blacks and Hispanics. And finally, we look at three different cancers, colon, breast, and prostate. So this is what the data set looks like. Here you see New York highlighted, and this is what the numbers look like for bone and joint cancer. So getting to colon cancer. So the solid bars represent Brooklyn, the textured bars represent the United States, and the gray bars represent blacks and Hispanics, while the yellow bars represent non-Hispanic whites. So as you can see, for blacks in Brooklyn, they have a much lower incidence than their white counterparts in Brooklyn. However, when you look at their mortality, you find the reverse is true, that they have a significantly greater mortality despite that low incidence. You look at their national counterparts, blacks and Hispanics, you find that they have a higher incidence and mortality than white counterparts in the United States. The same thing is true when you look at breast cancer, that despite a significantly lower incidence of blacks and Hispanics in Brooklyn, they have a higher mortality, has much greater mortality than non-Hispanic whites that live in Brooklyn as well. And now you start seeing the same trend in national blacks and Hispanics, where they have a lower incidence, yet a higher mortality. So a very disturbing picture. Now for prostate cancer, you find a different story where blacks and Hispanics in Brooklyn have a greater incidence than white counterparts, and an even greater mortality. And the same thing is true for black and Hispanics nationally. Now I want to point your attention to the amount, the magnitude of incidence and mortality that blacks and Hispanics have for colon cancer in Brooklyn. No other race or region comes close to the incidence mortality that they have in Brooklyn. For example, if you look at the white counterparts, it's almost two times the incidence and three times the mortality in Brooklyn for prostate cancer. So the key takeaways here is that for colon and breast, blacks and Hispanics in Brooklyn, despite a lower incidence, suffer a much greater mortality. And for prostate, Blacks, Hispanics, and Brooklyn have a significantly greater incidence and even higher mortality than non-Hispanic white counterparts. So I'd like to thank my co-authors of this study, Lakia Maxwell and Dr. Hannah Straker, who run Brooklyn Health Disparity Center. I'd also like to thank Suriname Medical Center for providing me resources to do the study, as well as Arthur Ashe Institute for Urban Health, who helped me with outreach. And finally, I'd like to thank healthdisparity.org, which is an organization that I founded soon after doing this research, that organizes forums and communities of color for about 4,000 students and teaches them about public health and health disparities, and encouraging them to take action in their own communities to help alleviate these disparities. And this is what the website looks like. Thank you very much. So the core mission of healthdisparity.org is really that peer-to-peer communication is the most effective way that students will be able to internalize the problems of health disparities and really feel empowered to take action to prevent them. I host the lectures myself and I lead them, and we've had very positive impacts already with students. For example, at one community center where we presented to only about 30 students, seven of them took their parents for colonoscopies, and two of them actually found polyps in their colon and had early treatment. So, it's very easy, it's very cheap, affordable, and is not that time intensive for students to actually feel empowered to take the action to help improve the health of their communities.
Around what happens if I have a positive screen. So there's so many